Yes, lads, and we're back. It's the one you've all been waiting for. Swindon Town, Road to Glory, and we're finally here. Season 5, I think it is now. After going through the low leagues for League 2, League 1, and now the Championship, we're finally moving on in the world. We're into the promised land. We've made it, finally, into the Premier League. So without further ado, let's get into this. Guys, I'm very sorry for the delay, but we are finally back. After popular demand, we're going to begin with multiple episodes for this season, just to break it apart, just to give it a bit more drama as well. And as you can see here, we're going to be playing against the big boys. We finally made it. Oh, I'm so excited for the season, I cannot explain. Alright, so it's been a while, so let's have a look at how our team's currently looking at. And as you can see, these lads got us through the Championship last year in absolutely fantastic style. But we're definitely going to need to make some signings if we're going to have any hope of hanging around in this league longer than one season. It's also worth mentioning that Keshi Anderson's going to be out for, I think, about 5 months still. He ended up doing his ligaments in the end of last season, so don't expect to see much of him this year. So, as you can see here, the board were absolutely over the moon with how we were last season. I bloody hope so. We went nearly like 33, 34 games unbeaten. It's what I expect them to be, do you know what I mean? The objectives they've set, a bit disappointed. They just want us to stay up. They've got no other ambitions other than just keeping us up in the league. And as well as that, as you can see here, a Europa League objective, which is really weird. But I'll come back to that later on. Taking a look at the budget, oh boys, this is beautiful. We've got just over 30 million to work with. So we can bring in some very good players this season. I'm very excited for that. So kicking off the first bit of news, as we all know, Zach Medley, he was only a loanee last season. He's now gone back to Arsenal, but we're not worried about that. We're worried about who we can bring in. And as you can see here, I'm sitting down with Jurgen. It's a lad that I spoke about last season quite a lot. It's Harry Wilson. Went in with a 10.2 million offer, below his value. He snapped my hand off, went in for the contract negotiations. Offered him slightly less than what he's currently on, but he was more than happy to play for Swindon. He wants to work with us. He's bought in to what we're going to be doing this season. This is a club that's gone through everything from day one all the way to the bottom of League 2 pretty much. And now, we're not only in the Premier League, potentially got European football this season as well. There he is, holding up the number 23 shirt. As well as him, I brought in Ben Acker, I think that's how you say his name. Got him from West Brom, got him for a very good deal. He's going to pad out our midfield quite a lot, because I think we definitely need to improve that area. And as well as him, as you can see here, he's a career mode favourite. I see pretty much every single YouTuber buy him in their career modes, and he always seems to be amazing. I've gone with the big boy Chong, best haircut in the game, I think, by absolute miles. Expecting big, big things from him. Now, really annoyingly, the media think we're going to come to their bottom, and I hate it when the media do this, because it just motivates me more to just make sure that that's completely wrong. I'm looking at mid-table, that's what I want. Just above mid-table, potentially looking at like 6th or 7th, and I know it's quite a big ask, but I think we're capable of that, boys. I think we can do this. So, taking a look at our actual team that we're going to be going with. Telecrossdale up top, of course. Velasquez will be starting, Chong and Wilson straight in, but as is Benaka. Yasin Adli, he'll also be starting no matter what. James Wilson will get a lot of game time this season, especially with the more fixtures we're going to have. Mitchell and Adekanye, they're going to have to be from the bench. I don't think they've got quite enough about them to be starting. And then looking at the rest of our squad, you can see we've still got Willery, he's still kicking about. Still got Solly Price. We've got some players in there from day one, so. Alright, so taking a look at how this video is going to pan out. We're going to go over our first game, which is Leicester away. That's going to be our first Premier League match ever. Then we're going to follow that up with our first home game of the season against Southampton. And then we'll wrap up the episode off to the Olympic Stadium against West Ham. So, without further ado, let's get into these games. Alright lads, here we are. First Premier League game. We're against Leicester. Lineup I've gone with, Taylor Crossett up top. Chong and Wilson make their debuts. But let's quiz the number 10 role. Benaka makes his debut too. Adli net alongside him. Dan Peters is our captain. Reece Oxford and Andrew Bio centre-backs. Tom Edwards are right-back. And our beast, Harvey Green, in goal. Boys, I'm so excited for this season. We've worked so hard to finally get to the Premier League, and then we're actually here. It doesn't quite feel real yet. We're going to need to be at it right from the off of the season. The level of quality is going to be such a big step up from last season. Basically every game is going to feel like our cup final. We played a couple of Premier League teams along the way on our journey, but playing them week in, week out is going to be a much more difficult test. It's not a better start against Leicester. They've actually won the Premier League before. It's still incredible when you think about it. It's a perfect opportunity to showcase exactly what we can do. Like I said earlier, I think that we can be going for a mid-table kind of finish. I don't just want to be a team that's trying to scrap to stay up all season. You can see the boys showing great squad harmony. A lot of them have been together since day one. And we're finally off. Boys, I am seriously, I've said it so many times already, but I'm so excited for this season. And we know previously that goals have always been pretty easy to come by. But this season, I think they might be a bit more difficult. We're going to have to focus on our defending a lot more. opening 6 minutes. Leicester work it really well. They managed to find a way through and just at the side netting. Get away with that one there. 11 minutes on the clock, Velasquez has a go from distance. The keeper collects it quite easily. He goes to clear it long. Adley wins the header, gives it to Taylor Crossdale, plays it to Velasquez. It's back to Taylor Crossdale. First touch, smashes it into the top of the corner. Oh, that is how we open up our season. This boy is showing that he can score at every level of football. Exactly what I want to be seeing. Perfect start to our season. Adley winning that header. It's a brilliant bit of play between Velasquez and Taylor Crossdale. Doesn't even need a first touch. Just lets it run across him. Smashes it on the swerve, right past the keeper. Perfect start. 22 minutes in, Adley gives the ball to Banaka. Almost scores a screamer. Just a little bit too high. Coming up to the 40th minute. Leicester working really well down the right hand side. Playing brilliant passes. Can't quite get near him. And somehow, Bakayoko, it's a good little turn. Finds himself unmarked. Drags his shot just wide. And hang on to our lead. Silly mistake from Harvey Green resulting from that effort. Luckily, the chip just goes wide. Oh, my heart was in my mouth at that point. 45 minutes in, Velasquez works really well. Gets it to Oxford. Gives it to Adebayo. No one puts a challenge in. He goes unmarked. Taylor Crossdale gives it to Adley. Goes 1-1. Keeper makes a great save. Coming into the second half, Leicester whip it across. It's dealt with well. And then Bolo just sends his volley wide. Moments later, Wilson gives it to Banaka. He's got not much on. Sends it out wide to Chong. Plays it into Taylor Crossdale. Sends it through the middle to Velasquez. Hits the post, makes it 2-0. Sends us absolutely wild. We're in dreamland. This is the perfect opening game. A little bit of a cheeky celebration as well. That's what I like to see. Just over the hour mark, Naka pinches the ball from in the midfield, gives it to Wilson. Sends it back to Edwards. Gives it to Adley. He looks up, gives it back to Wilson. Tees it off to Ted Crossdale. Gives it to Chong very unselfishly. He gets his first for the club on his debut. 3-0 the final score. On we go to our first home game of the season against Southampton. Went with the same team, completely unchanged. 5 minutes in, Southampton force a great save from Harvey Green. 20 minutes in, Edwards gets caught out a little bit by Oyinnassi, sends him absolutely flying. Southampton, a few stepovers. Adebayo can't get close, and Green has to make another good save. We were properly under the pressure in this game, and then a poor clearance. We go 1-0 down. 36 minutes in, Chong, he's not got much on, thinks in a cross. Great first touch from Velasquez, but can't do much more than that. 51 minutes in, Southampton play a brilliant pass through, completely carved open the defence. Green comes flying out, makes a good block, but the rebound falls so kindly. Southampton make it 2-0. Straight from kickoff, we lose the ball. It's very, very poor. Velasquez wins it straight back, gives it to Chong. Sends it out wide to Dan Peters. Shows a great bit of pace. He's got the option to the middle, whips it in. We rattle the crossbar. Oh, so annoying. So close to get back into this game. Moments later, Southampton, they break through again. Dodgy cross comes in. Chong gets left exposed at the back. They go 3-0 up. Lads were all over the place. It was such a harsh wake-up call from the game we just had. And then, just coming up to the hour mark, this absolute bullet hits the post. Get very lucky. They get the rebound. 4-0. I wanted to get us out of here as quickly as possible. This game was quickly becoming an embarrassment. Vanessa smashes the post, but we couldn't do nothing about it. Take a look at the player ratings. Nobody did themselves any justice in that game at all. So moving on very swiftly to our last game for these highlights. We're off to the Olympic Stadium. I needed an instant response. Inside the opening minute, Taylor Crossdale wins the ball, gives it to Adley. Sends a little pass over top to Wilson. First in the box, gets taken out. Unfortunately, he ended up getting injured after that. We won the penalty, which is the main thing. Taylor Crossdale steps up to redeem himself from the last game, sends it in the bottom corner, gives us a perfect start, exactly what I wanted to see. Now, like I was saying, I wanted an instant reaction, and the boys were right at it from this one. Lovely pass into Chong, tees up Taylor Crossdale, 1-1, you know what's next. Top corner, this boy has got goals in him, it's exactly what we need this season. Adebayo almost made it 3, but his header just went over, and then coming up to the end of the first half, West Ham working quite well, Harvey Green. That has got to be the save of the entire series. How he's got a fingertip to that, I don't even know. Incredible save. In the end, we managed to hang on for a famous win. Like I said, Wilson, he ended up getting injured. He's out for 8 weeks, which is not what I wanted to be seeing after just signing him. Now, I mentioned it earlier, the boys, we are in Europe this season. It's absolutely incredible. Getting to the FA Cup final last season actually had its value, because we're in the Europa League. European football for Swindon. So as the draws come along, we can see we went in one of the first four groups. We're joining Group H. We've been drawn against the likes of Atletico, Galatasaray, and Helsinki. It's definitely going to be an interesting group, and I'm very excited to see how we get on in Europe. So taking a look at the league table, as I said, I want to be mid-table, pushing on 6th to 7th. Exactly where we are at the minute, 7th. 2 wins and a loss, scored 5, conceded 4. We definitely need to improve the defence early on. So for the next video, I think we're going to go up to about match day 15, just to get quite a few games under our belts, just so we can see how we're getting on. If you did enjoy the video, make sure you leave it a like and subscribe. It does mean a lot to me. The more love you show the video, the quicker I can get the map out for you guys to enjoy. So, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.